The FBI is pretty good at their job, though they still haven't found me. Sometimes criminals think they are even better than the feds. Therefore, they try their absolute hardest to avoid paying for the crimes they have committed. From a man who killed his wife hours after their wedding, to another who killed his family and blew up his house, here are 10 of the most wanted people the FBI are looking for right now. Before we begin, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification bell for more amazing videos every day. With that being said, let's begin. Number 10. Robert William Fisher. To look at Robert William Fisher's mugshot, he doesn't look all that scary. He certainly doesn't have murderer written all over him, but maybe he should, for it might help the FBI find him a little easier. This man is wanted for unlawful flight to avoid prosecution, 3 counts of first-degree murder, and arson of an occupied structure. According to the FBI, Robert is wanted for a crime that happened in Scottsdale, Arizona in 2001. Allegedly, Robert killed his wife and 2 children, then blew up his house. The FBI is offering a reward of $100,000 for anyone who can provide information that leads to his arrest. Robert was born in April 1961 in Brooklyn, New York. He has brown hair, blue eyes, and is thought to be 6 feet tall and 190 pounds. He's of medium build, with light skin, and has surgical scars on his lower back. Other identifying features include an exaggerated and erect posture due to a back injury and a gold crown on his tooth. Before he allegedly committed these crimes of which he's now being sought for, Robert was a surgical catheter technician, fireman, and respiratory therapist. He is considered armed and dangerous, so anyone who thinks they spot Robert Fisher is advised to call their local FBI office. It's time for the star topic. Anyone in a mask can be terrifying in the right situation. Just think how spooky Halloween season is. However, this mask is something totally different. Take a look. This man in a white mask featuring black stripes appears in actual CCTV footage from one of the biggest robberies in Madrid, Spain. It is one of the last ever photos taken of the suspect, and no one knows who he is. So, until the mystery man is identified, no one will be arrested for this massive crime. Comment down below with the hashtag #StarTopic, and we might pin the best comment in relation to this image. And now to the next topic. Number 9. Eugene Palmer. New York-born Eugene Palmer is wanted for the alleged murder of his daughter-in-law outside her property in Stony Point, New York. This white male with gray balding hair and a deformed left thumb hid in the woods near his home and ambushed her. As his daughter-in-law, Tammy Palmer, walked away, he shot her 3 times with a shotgun, with 2 of the 3 shots hitting her in the arm and chest. Tammy died from her injuries, and Eugene fled in his pickup truck, which he abandoned, near Harriman State Park. Eugene has never been found, but he is presumed to be alive. Eugene is thought to have killed his daughter-in-law after she separated from his son, John. The pair lived next door to Eugene. Tammy had filed a restraining order against John, which made Eugene mad and created a feud. Many people believe Eugene died in Harriman State Park, but no body has been found. Therefore, he remains one of the 10 most wanted people the FBI is looking for. Number 8. Arnaldo Yimimez. Texas-born Arnaldo Yimimez is wanted for first-degree murder and unlawful flight to avoid prosecution. In 2012, Arnaldo Yimimez had just married Estrella Carrera, with whom he had 2 children. Within hours, she was dead, and Arnaldo Yimimez is thought to have killed her. The pair had been out for dinner before heading to a nightclub. On the morning of May 12, they had headed home around 4 a.m. On the way, Estrella and Arnaldo argued, and Arnaldo allegedly stabbed her several times in his 4-door Maserati before dragging her body into her apartment. He then dumped her in the bathtub in the same dress she had worn to their wedding. Investigators tracked calls made by Arnaldo and placed him in Hidalgo, Mexico. In September that year, police also arrested Arnaldo's brother on drug charges and found his Maserati, containing Estrella's blood, in his garage. Police believe Arnaldo's brother drove him to Mexico, where he is still thought to be hiding. The FBI is offering up to $100,000 for any information that leads to Arnaldo Yimimez's arrest. Number 7. Alejandro Rosales Castillo. Alejandro Rosales Castillo, who has several aliases, is wanted for the murder of his former girlfriend and co-worker in Charlotte, North Carolina, in August 2016. At just age 18, Alejandro allegedly shot and killed a woman he had worked with and had been in a relationship with. The Hispanic teen, born in Arizona in 1998, has not been seen since surveillance footage showed him crossing the border from Arizona into Mexico on August 16, 2016. The victim's vehicle was found in Phoenix, Arizona, at a bus stop, while her body was located in the woods in Cabarrus County, North Carolina, 2 days later. She had a single gunshot wound to the head. Police believe Alejandro may be in Aguascalientes, or could now be in the Mexican states of Veracruz or Guanajuato. He has black hair, brown eyes, and is thought to weigh between 180 and 190 pounds. The FBI is offering up to $100,000 for information that leads to his arrest. However, anyone who believes they see him should be warned that he's considered armed and dangerous, an escape risk, and has violent tendencies. Number 6. Yasser Adbel Said. Yasser Adbel Said, an Egyptian resident of the United States, is wanted for murdering his two teenage daughters in Irving, Texas in 2008. Yasser is thought to have lured his daughters, Amina and Sarah, into his taxicab, which he drove for a living, with the offer of going out to eat. Instead, he fatally shot and killed them and remains at large. Yasser's wife, Patricia Owens, claims that Yasser abused her during their marriage. The teenage daughters had also claimed Yasser had sexually and physically abused them. Yasser had not believed his daughters were abiding by traditional Islamic cultural behavior and killed them as a result. There is no record that Yasser has left the country, but he could be hiding with friends. The FBI also thinks he could be driving cabs in New York City. In 2014, Yasser was added to the 10 most wanted list, with a $100,000 reward advertised for information that leads to his capture. Number 5. Jason Derek Brown. Jason Derek Brown, who goes by the aliases Derek, Greg, Harleen, John, and Jay, is wanted for first-degree murder, armed robbery, and unlawful flight to avoid prosecution. In 2004, a hooded gunman, which fingerprints show to be Jason, shot and killed Robert Keith Palomares, a 24-year-old armored car guard, outside the AMC Theater in Phoenix. The victim was shot in the head 5 times with a Glock pistol and was later pronounced dead. The gunman fled the scene on a bike with around $56,000 in cash, and Jason became a suspect. Soon after, he fled to Nevada before swapping out his vehicle in Las Vegas. After tracking him to Portland, Oregon, the FBI lost track of him. Given his surfer appearance, Jason may be able to blend into crowds with ease. FBI believes he could be in Thailand, France, in a Mormon community, or with someone who does not know his true identity. Jason left behind his luxurious lifestyle, where he is thought to have defaulted on a significant loan and owe thousands of dollars. The robbery was considered to relate to these debts. In 2007, Jason was added to the FBI's most wanted list, and a reward of $200,000 is offered for information that leads to his capture. The last sighting of him was by an old acquaintance in Salt Lake City, near Hoggle Zoo, in 2008. Number 4. Alexis Flores. Alexis Flores, who also goes by Alex, Alesis, and Mario, is wanted for the 2000 kidnapping, rape, and murder of a 5-year-old girl, as well as unlawful flight to avoid prosecution. The Honduras-born man of slim build with light complexion had been a homeless drifter and was given work, clothing, and shelter in Philadelphia. During this time, 5-year-old Ariana De Jesus was found in an empty apartment building where Alexis had been working. She had been assaulted, strangled, and wrapped in a trash bag. A t-shirt with a political logo on it was found with her blood on it near the scene, which was traced back to the man who had given Alexis the work as an article of clothing he had gifted Alexis. Given his many identities, Alexis was able to fly under the radar, even when he was arrested for shoplifting in 2002 in Arizona. When his DNA sample was taken in 2007, it matched DNA found at the crime scene. FBI believes Alexis is either in Honduras or the United States and is thought to be armed and dangerous. They have released a $100,000 reward for information that leads to his capture. Number 3. Bhadresh Kumar Chettanbhai Patel. Bhadresh Kumar Chettanbhai Patel is wanted for the murder of his wife, Palak Patel, in a donut store where the pair worked, in Hanover, Maryland. The couple had been working together on the night of April 12, 2015, when surveillance footage showed Bhadresh Kumar and Palak walking into the kitchen and out of sight. Only Bhadresh Kumar returned, where he turned off an oven and left the store. Customers concerned about the lack of employees in the store notified police, who found Palak beaten and stabbed to death. Police believe a disagreement over returning to their homeland of India could have led to the murder. Given the half-hour window between the death and surveillance footage viewing, Bhadresh Kumar was able to return to his apartment on foot, grab some possessions, then take a cab to a hotel near the Newark, New Jersey airport. He checked out the following morning, was seen at Newark Penn Station, and has not been seen since. Police believe Bhadresh Kumar could be hiding with family or has left the country. There is a $100,000 reward for information that leads to his arrest. Number 2. Santiago Villalba Medeiros. Santiago Villalba Medeiros, an alleged murderer and gang member, is wanted for a whole host of charges. In separate incidences, the FBI wishes to locate him for unlawful flight to avoid prosecution, first-degree murder, first-degree attempted murder, conspiracy to commit murder in the first degree, unlawful possession of a firearm in the second degree, and second-degree murder. Santiago was 18 years old and part of the Eastside Lakota Sureños gang in Washington in 2005 when he committed his first murder. He was driving a stolen van with six other gang members on the hunt for rival gang members who had been responsible for a shooting a few days before. Seeing Josh and Camille Love, siblings, dressed in red, Santiago mistook them for a pair of rival gang members and shot into the vehicle. Camille died, and Josh was seriously wounded. 5 years later, Santiago and other gang members ransacked a car in South Tacoma. They got into a fight with the men who confronted them, and Santiago shot at them, killing a 25-year-old man. Once again, Santiago had mistaken the man for a gang member, which he was not. Santiago has ties in both Mexico and Washington State, and he's considered armed and dangerous. Number 1. Rafael Caro Quintero. Rafael Caro Quintero would have to be one of the most sought-after fugitives in the whole of the United States. With a $20 million reward for his arrest, he is wanted for a string of crimes dating back to the 1980s. Rafael, of Mexican descent, has ties in Mexico and Costa Rica. He is 6 foot, around 170 pounds, and speaks Spanish. He is wanted for conspiracy to commit and committing violent crimes in aid of racketeering, kidnapping, and conspiracy to kidnap a federal agent, felony murder of a federal agent, and accessory after the fact. He is armed and extremely dangerous and should not be approached. Can you believe these fugitives could be walking our streets? Do any of them look familiar? Do you think you've seen any of them in your neck of the woods? Can you guess which crime I've committed? Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on the screen now. See you next time!